Okay, so this whole Smokey and the Bandit business actually started a few days ago. I was sitting in my office, minding my own business, when my buddy Jay Ricky just showed up.
Ha! What are you doing in town, man? What's up, man?
Now, Jay's not exactly hurting for cash, so he gave me 70 grand to deliver a tricked out Smokey and the Bandit Trans Am, but there's a catch.
I actually need it for a rally
in 6 days.
By 3 p.m.
You're insane, dude. Thanks for the watch.
Now, he knows that's not nearly enough to get a Bandit Trans Am done that fast. But instead of just forking over the cash, Jay wants to make a bet instead.
Take this 70 to build a car, and I'll throw in another 40K. If you can deliver it to me in time to make my race.
If you don't have it in 6 days, in New Orleans,
no extra 40K for you, bub.
That's it.
Based on all the flakes you're seeing, you might think that Josh had just brushed his teeth with his fingers. But in fact, that's not the case at all. This is what appears to be cam, lifter, maybe some cam bearing. This is a major problem. This is, as a matter of fact, a catastrophe.
Dude, the truck is still out there. Why is this thing in the air? Why are you taking parts off of it?
It's not parts, it's the whole motor.
What?
Motor's no good. We don't know.
We just built it.
Mm-hmm. You're right, we just did. And we test drove it and it failed the test.
Does it just run bad? Will it make it, or?
It's equally as damaged as it was before in an entirely different way.
How do we know that? Did it quit running, or?
Look at the oil.
Shimmery. That's not good.
Yeah, that's a little beyond shimmer.
3 o'clock tomorrow.
Well, like I said, the first part of fixing the problem is establishing what's wrong. And rather than playing with it in the car, we're just gonna go ahead and take it out and we're gonna run it down to Jamie's. If it's cam bearings and cam, well, then we'll just do that. If it's connecting rod, we've got another crank down there and we'll just see how fast we can get it done. Unless you can call and get me another running motor right now from someone else.
Dude,
we're gonna the motor out and try and fix it.
I don't know what to do. I know, we do.
We're taking the motor out so we can try and fix it. 2.5 hours, I'll be able to tell you if you have a chance of winning still or if you're completely screwed.
Oh, God.
You ready?
All right, go up.
Listen, we can go take it. So we just got through tearing the motor down, wanted to check it out real quick. We don't know completely what the problem is, but we did find one massive one. The noise that Jordan was hearing was this connecting rod, which is a major fail.
Okay.
So Jordan is gonna take the motor to Jamie, and if Jamie can build the motor in, I don't know, like the next 6 hours, we still have a chance of making it to New Orleans by the deadline.
Good enough.
If not, looks like Tripp's pretty much screwed.
All right. So here's the deal. It's an 8-hour drive from Dallas to New Orleans, which means the car needs to leave by 7 a.m. to make it there by 3 p.m. And the transport truck, well, it's long gone. So if I have to, I'll drive this thing there. I'll take off the second that car's done. But the guys are staying here tonight until it's done. Aaron's gonna stay here tonight until it's done. And if he has to jump in the car with me, we'll be there at 3 o'clock. I'm not gonna lose his bet.
Got a call from Jordan today about 4 o'clock to bring us the motor back for the Trans Am.
I made it.
Damn, man. What are y'all doing?
Man, I don't know what happened to it. I just know it all of a sudden started knocking, and we pulled it out. We went ahead and pulled the oil pan off of it, and we're pretty sure that it's got a rod bearing bed.
You've been doing donuts, haven't you?
I haven't personally, but I can't tell you about anyone else at the shop.
Well, all right, man, let's get this thing out and see if we can't work our magic. Question is, when's it got to be done?
Well, I was hoping we could do it tonight.
Tonight? For real?
Richard has a deadline in the morning. I'm gonna stay here and hang out with y'all and help y'all with whatever y'all need. So pretty much that means I'm y'all's gopher. Cool?
All right, well, let's get it done. It'll be an all-nighter.
All right, well, let's get this thing out.
How you drive this truck?
First thing we do when we get an engine back, we have to tear it down, clean it, evaluate it, see what happened to it.
So how's it all coming along?
Pretty good. Look like the pan's been sucked dry.
What do you think happened? Why would it have done that?
Sucked the pan dry.
Pretty much cavitated the motor.
Right.
I guess let's go ahead and get it fixed.
All the metal shavings in the oil was from the fuel in the oil. The fuel breaks down the oil, and then there's no lubricant on the bearings. The bearings are completely chewed up. It's gonna have to be completely redone. Gas Monkey is absolutely one of our most important clients here. So we're gonna stay late, get this thing done, get it rebuilt, get it back on the road, because I know they're dying to get it back.
Right now, Mike is honing out the cylinders. It's step two on God knows how many, but he's as fast as they come. I've got Aaron and Richard on standby, so when it's done, we can meet back at the shop and get this motor back in the Trans Am.
All right, man, there's our motor.
When we got it over to Jamie's, we got it ripped down. We found out that not one, but all the bearings had been totally destroyed in the motor. It ruined our crankshaft. Luckily, he had another crankshaft there. We were able to resize the rods, hone the motor, and put it all back together. And we did it in actually record time. We did it in about 5.5 hours this time.
How long is it gonna take you to get it back together?
At least 2 hours.
Well, this is it. 90 grand on the line. 2 hours to get the motor in, a few more to test and tune. Odds are bad, even for me.
I thought you were driving.
I thought you were driving.
I've been up all night.
Me too.
Paper covers rock. Playing with a master.
All right, man. 6.5 hours to make an 8-hour trip.
It'll be hard.
Hey, J-Rock, have the cash ready. I'll be there by 3.
It's back now, loaded up and trucking. We gonna do what they say can't be done. We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'll be bound, just watch your bandit run.
We got 6 miles, man. We're almost there, it's getting close. I don't know where to turn. If you pull this thing up on the map, everything's one way, the wrong way.
I know, man. Come on.
Well, we're definitely in the French Quarter.
We're about 5 minutes out. Richard's not here. Didn't think he was going to make it. The bet was that he had to bring me a truck full of beer and meet me here on Rampart Street when he delivered the car. Truck's here. He's just not.
I want one more block.
People are walking around on bicycles.
Can't you see I'm trying to win a bet?
Right here.
How are we doing on time, man? Are we all right?
Well, you don't even wear a watch. How would you know?
Indian time says we're close.
God.
Down to 2 minutes. 2 minutes.
Yeah, you got your stuff.
All right, I'm trying. Is it this one?
Turn right here.
It's the one before?
It's
the one before Conti going this way.
Yeah, it's not.
But that's...
Oh, you want to go the wrong way?
No. Yes. 90 G's, dude. 90.
Right.
I got it. Dude, there he is.
Uh-oh.
Get you some of that, Rocky. 259.
You went the wrong way,
bro.
Down a one-way street.
The important thing is we're here. You got to do 259.
Woo! Richard and Aaron screaming, smoking tires, coming the wrong way down Rampart Street.
Synchronized, man. You gave me this watch. It says 259.
Sliding into the finish line with not a minute to spare. Unbelievable.